Here's the squad. Riley, don't mess around in the back. Okay.
Something else.
Okay. So today we're going to be talking about cardiovascular system. The cardiovascular system is the heart, blood, veins, and arteries that supply blood to the rest of the body. The cardiovascular system has many functions: oxygen and carbon dioxide transport. So it transports oxygen to the working muscles and carbon dioxide out as you're working. Nutrient and waste product transport, disease protection, hormone delivery, and body temperature regulation. Blood flows through the heart. It starts in the veins, and then your venous return brings it to the right atrium. It goes through the tricuspid valve. It goes through the tricuspid valve, then the right ventricle, through the pulmonary aorta to the lungs, and then back to the pulmonary veins, to the left atrium, then to the left ventricle, and then the aortic arch, and then to the rest of the body, to capillaries and things like that.
After talking to our group about blood flow through the heart, we had them race healthy heart against healthy heart. Then we had them race again, healthy heart versus unhealthy heart. After the activity, we talked to them about cardiovascular disease and preventative measures for health and nutrition in the heart.
Okay. All right. This group, come here. That's why I
don't want to. No. Y'all just stay over here. This is y'all's heart. Y'all are going to do the same thing on this heart that they're doing on this heart.
Pay attention to me. Y'all are going to be doing what I do here on that one, obviously. Okay? So, you're going to start. Come in, touch this, you go up, through here, you go around this.
That's the lungs, you're getting oxygen
that's
from
the lungs.
Lungs.
Now I'm going to left ventricle, touch here, out, through the aorta.
And finish.
And when I cross here, the next person can go.
Okay. Wait, you go back.
Thank you.
team that lost had to do a disease chart, so you had some blocks in the way, things like that. It's from your diet, sedentary lifestyle, things like that. And I know I was watching this team, and they seem to be having some trouble. They're a little bit mad about their obstacles in the way. Well, you know, if you don't want that, you got to eat healthy, you got to stay active, and do what you do to keep your cardiovascular system healthy.
And win the game the next presentation.
And next time you can win. But, appreciate everybody.
All right. Does anybody, without looking at the definition, know what atherosclerosis is?
No.
Basically, it's the hardening of blood vessels in your body because of nutrition, lack of fitness, and other unhealthy lifestyle choices. So basically, how this happens is you have somebody who doesn't work out, who sits around the house all day, eating just junk food, and on the weekends, they go get drunk and do crazy stuff and just do damage to their body. And they don't ever do anything physical. They don't do any kind of physical activity. So their veins, they don't ever constrict, they don't ever dilate. And so they get hardened in their body. And that could cause a whole number of problems, including during exercise, there's pain in the legs specifically. You could have a heart attack, a stroke, erectile dysfunction, man. Not good. Can you have atherosclerosis and have an athletic lifestyle problem? Usually athletes don't have this kind of problem, and if they do, it's genetic and they can't help it. And atherosclerosis is a cardiovascular disease, which we're about to talk about. There are many cardiovascular disease risk factors, and these aren't just random things that could lead to heart disease. These are come up with by, you know, medical professionals and all kinds of stuff. And so basically, I'm about to go through the chart of all these. These are all different risk factors that if it applies to you, you get a point. And points are not good in this situation. If you get certain points, then it'll be hard for you to work out, and especially under somebody who's like a personal trainer or a medical specialist who's trying to get you in shape. So the criteria for age is if you're 45 or older for men or 55 or older for women, you get a point. So basically, that's saying that there's a chance of you having cardiovascular disease when you get older. You can't help it. That's just how it happens. Family history. This is also something you can't control. If there is myocardial infarction, which basically is a heart attack, if there's that big R word, or sudden death because of heart disease in males or females over 55 or 65 in your family, you get a point for that. So basically, if your family has heart disease, you probably will get a point. Smoking. So you can, this is kind of crazy to me, I don't really understand this one, but you can smoke for 10 years of your life, but if you stop and 6 months later you go and start working out and you haven't smoked in 6 months, you'll be fine. So you can be a 10-year smoker and stop for 6 months and you'll be fine, according to this chart. I don't really agree with that, but that's how it works. Hypertension. Basically, this is blood pressure. You have high blood pressure.
And a lot of these things, it's good to know that some of them you can't help and some of them you can. You know, you can obviously control your diet, you can control your nutrition, and you know, what you're doing, putting in your body drugs, alcohol, cigarettes, things like that. But a lot of them you can't. You know, you can't change your age, you can't change your family history, and you can't change, you know, if you have hypertension really, because that's genetic. It's passed down through genes, so.
Does anybody know what HDLs and LDLs dyslipidemia is? Somebody know what that's talking about? That's cholesterol. And if you didn't know, LDLs are bad. That stands for low density lipids, and HDL stands for high density. So if you're high density, you're real compact, and you're not taking up a whole lot of space. So if you have HDLs in your blood, that's good. They don't take up a lot of space, and you don't get blood clots. If you have LDLs, that's bad. So if you have LDLs higher than 130 milligrams per deciliter of blood, that's a bad thing, and that gives you a point. If your HDLs are lower than 40 milligrams, there's like a proportion there. You need to have high HDLs and low LDLs. Usually when people talk about cholesterol, they're talking about LDLs. That's bad. Prediabetes or diabetes, basically, this time about your blood glucose levels, you won't really have that problem unless you're diabetic. Obesity. Unlike what Will was just saying, this is definitely something you can control. If you're fit, if you're athletic, if you watch your weight, if you eat good, if you're sedentary, you're definitely this is the next one, sedentary lifestyle. And that's kind of like a, it says you have to have accumulate 30 minutes or more activity on most days of the week. That's kind of like an opinion thing. So depending on who you're talking about, or who you're talking to, like I said, personal trainers use this, doctors use this, anybody who will regulate a workout program or evaluate your health through a workout program will use these cardiovascular risk factor disease. So then this is what I was talking about, the stratification on these risks. If you get one or less points, you're low risk and you're good to work out. You don't have to get a medical screen, you don't have to take any kind of medication or anything. Moderate risk is greater than or equal to two. And you're not necessary to take a medical exam for this one, but whoever your professional is, whoever's training you, whoever you're taking through workouts, they definitely need to watch you and make sure you're doing okay. High risk is, I think it's more than two, or if you have diabetes, I think. Yeah.
Yeah, and on your automatic high risk, if your parents have died from a heart attack at an early age, things like that, that's automatic high risk. You need clearance to exercise, things like that. So you can have almost as many points as on the risk factors, but if you have those things, it's automatic high risk and you have to have clearance. So.
All right, and that wraps up the risk stratification.
Okay, so this is preventive action. Obviously, you guys are all athletes. Y'all work out and y'all are active and things like that. But one of the big things I started thinking about is when you're done playing, or like if you don't stay active, this can still happen to you, especially if you're used to what you were eating when you were an athlete, when you spend hours and hours doing things and then all of a sudden it stops and you continue eating like you were. This can cause a real problem, especially after 10, 20 years. You can develop a cardiovascular disease. Like I was talking about earlier, you can only control what you control. You can't change your age, things like that. So your lifestyle choices, diet, and exercise are really the only things that you can do to help your cardiovascular system. Diet, this is just some tips, really. This is one of the bigger indicators, is diet. Some tips are eat 5 portions of fruits, have starches in every meal, avoid fatty foods, try to eat fish 2 to 3 times a week, especially oily fish, and then limit your salt, which is another very good thing. That's it.